Hello friends, welcome back in a Lapi care. Today we are going to see North Bridge, which is a very important. Function of the North Bridge is to give a display to the motherboard. When power on no display cases, 90% chances there is a North Bridge is a faulty. So, which is a most important and widely or mostly occur problem in a motherboard, that is a power on but no display, or sometime dead because of a North Bridge. So which is very important topic. So let's see, this is a North Bridge and there are a tiny capacitor on the North Bridge. There is a three supplies on the North Bridge. One RAM supply, which is from the this RAM slot to the capacitor on the North Bridge. Second is a AGP supply, AGP accelerator graphics port. This is a VRM like circuit. This is AGP circuit, which is look like VRM circuit. Here is a some input capacitor, some output capacitor, coil, and TG MOSFET, BG MOSFET, and etc. This is a AGP circuit. And another one is a graphics. There is a one MOSFET, which is a graphics MOSFET. This is MOSFET, which is graphics, which provides supply to the graphics. So three supply come on this North Bridge, from RAM slot, from AGP circuit, and graphics. So let's test it. Some point to be remembered, that this first we have to find capacitor which are belong to the RAM circuit or AGP circuit or a graphic circuit, and this capacitor do not inter beep with each other. Like if this capacitor is belong to the graphics, so it should not beep with a AGP or a RAM circuit. Or if any capacitor like this capacitor belong to the RAM circuit, so it should not beep with graphics or AGP circuit. So this is an important point. Then another impedance. I will tell you how to calculate impedance. If impedance should not be less than 80, it is higher value above 100, 200 or 400. So impedance should not be 80. If impedance is in between 10 to 30, it is the North Bridge is not repairable. It is totally useless. If impedance is between 30 to 60 or 80, it is repairable. By hitting the North Bridge, it can be a repairable. But if it is greater than 80, then it is a okay. So first we check capacitor belong to the RAM circuit or a graphic circuit or AGP circuit. So let's try. First set our multimeter to the buzzer range. So this is a DDR2 motherboard. So pin number 53 is a supply pin of RAM slot. This is a pin number 53. So put place one probe on this 53 pin and check whether which capacitor on North Bridge is give buzzer. So let's see. No, this does not give beep. Means this is does not belong to the RAM circuit. This is also not. This also not. Okay, this capacitor give buzzer with RAM circuit. Means it is a belong to the RAM circuit. So remember, this is a RAM circuit capacitor. So check another. This is also, it give one side beep and another side no beep, because another side is a ground and one side is a supply, and supply give beeps. This is also RAM circuit capacitor. This does not give with RAM circuit, buzzer with RAM circuit, so it is does not belong to the RAM. This is belong to the RAM circuit. So let's check it. This is, I hope this is ground. No, this is not ground. Okay, this is actually, this is a, this motherboard having the north bridge problem. This is a dead motherboard, and because of this north bridge, so it give buzzer with another capacitor also, which is not belong to the RAM. They are interconnected, so this is a faulty. So for concept for understanding concept, only remember that we have to find the capacitor belong to RAM circuit and graphics circuit and AGP circuit, and they should not interconnect with each other. And impedance also, we have to calculate impedance also for our understanding. This capacitor, from this capacitor to this capacitor, are belong to the RAM circuit. So next, check from graphics. This is a MOSFET which is belong to the graphics circuit, and the source of this MOSFET is give supply on the capacitor of north bridge. I put one probe on source of the MOSFET and checking the capacitor. This capacitor belong to the graphics. This is also capacitor which is belong to the graphics circuit. This is also graphics. This graphics and this graphics, and this is the RAM which does not give with graphics. That's why now we have to find supply from the AGP. This is a AGP circuit. This is a AGP circuit, and this is a TG MOSFET. And from the drain of TG MOSFET, we have to get connectivity with the capacitor on the north bridge. So let's test it. This is belong to AGP. This also are belong to the AGP circuit. So we have to find all the capacitor belong to the AGP. That is, this all are AGP capacitor. This is a RAM capacitor, and this is a graphics capacitor. Now we have to calculate impedance. We have to place one probe, red probe, on a ground and another probe on a capacitor on a north bridge. So I place this red probe on a ground. Okay, here is a ground, and from the ground I place black probe on the capacitor on a capacitor on north bridge, and multimeter should show the value from one side and beep with another side. The value which comes on multimeter should be greater than 80, which is impedance. Now we have to calculate impedance. So red probe on a ground and black probe on a capacitor of north bridge, and in the multimeter, from one side it should be beep from ground side, and another side it gives value which is should be greater than 80. If this the value is greater than 80, the capacitor is okay. Otherwise, it is a faulty. If it is in between 30 to 80, it is repairable. But it is less than 80, then it is not repairable. So let's see it. I place red probe on ground and black probe on the multimeter, showing the value near around above 2330. Means which is the impedance of this capacitor, which is a high value, and from another side it will give a buzzer because it is a ground. So we have to calculate all the capacitor and calculate the value of all the capacitor. This is a ground side, it's showing the impedance of multimeter, which is a 2 or 1. And from another side, it is showing less value, so multimeter is giving buzzer. It is less than 80, so it is give buzzer. If its value is greater than 80, the multimeter will not buzzer. So this capacitor is a faulty. So another, this is also less than 80, so it is giving buzzer from this side. And this is a ground side, which is the impedance of the multimeter, which is 2. Now let's see another. This is giving a higher value, so it does not buzzer. From the opposite of this, which is ground, which is giving buzzer for impedance 2. Now let's see. This is higher than 80, 120, so it does not giving buzzer. So means impedance, which is very important. We can conclude this NOR bridge is repairable or not by value of impedance. 120, which is, the side is ground, so it is giving value 2. Now this is above 120, means this is a okay, it's acceptable, and which is it is showing a 29 value, which is not repairable. So this is a faulty motherboard. From this we have studied that how to check NOR bridge. I hope you guys you understand very well. If you have any problem, please mention in a comment box. I will bring new motherboard for your satisfaction and show all the circuits in details afterward. So please connected and please subscribe my channel for new upcoming videos. Thank you very much.